But I just thank God for Jesus on today that I was able to see myself. I was able to, sometimes we don't see ourselves, but I was able to see myself. And then I had to back up. I had to back up and go to the Lord on her behalf. And I did. And I know the Lord is working some things out. Oh, he's moving mightily. He is moving mightily. And I'm just looking for the finished work of that. God is doing some great things. God is doing some awesome things. And I just thank him on today. We have to learn to trust the Lord. We got to learn to trust the Lord and take him at his word. Proverbs 3 and 5 and 6, I believe. This is the Amplified version. Says, trust in the Lord and rely confidently on the Lord. So we can have confidence in him that he is going to do what he say he's going to do. He is not a man that he should lie. Only truth is in him. Only truth is in him. We can stand on his word because his word is truth. It doesn't matter what it looks like. I was in prayer one month, and I don't know really what I was praying about, but I began to say, Lord, it doesn't matter what it looked like. Your word is truth. Your word is the truth, and we can stand on your word. And it says, trust in the Lord and rely confidently on the Lord with all your heart and do not rely on your own. See, I was relying on my own, what I thought I knew, what I thought I knew how to do. But it's saying, don't rely on that. We can't rely on that because we'll go wrong every time. We cannot rely on that. We can't rely on our own insight. But it says, do not rely on your own insight or understanding. We have to go to God. We have to acknowledge God and allow him to come in and move in the situation and circumstances. So as we are moving through this 2022, God is doing some great things. God is doing some great things. I decided for 2022, I'm gonna be excited about Jesus. No matter what comes, no matter what go, because he fights the battle. The battles belong to the Lord. They don't belong to me. They belong to the Lord. Exodus 14 and 14 says, this is my scripture for the year. This is the one I'm holding on to for the year. Exodus 14 and 14. And it says, the Lord will fight for you while you only need to keep silent and remain calm. The Lord will fight for you. Dana, you only need to keep silent. Because you know, we heard it on Thursday night. Sometimes we just talk too much. Sometimes we just do too much. So he said, you keep silent and remain calm. Remain calm and see the salvation of the Lord. We have to see. We can watch it. We can see the salvation of the Lord. Because when they came back with Jehoshaphat and they did all of that, the Lord delivered them. The Lord delivered them out of the hand of the enemies. And the Lord is delivering us. Ephesians 6 and 10 says, finally, be strong in the Lord and the power of might. Finally, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. That's where we are today. And I believe that it is a good start to 2022. The Lord brought us through 2021. We stretched in 2021. The Lord took us to some different places in 2021. For me, it was a transitional year. 2021 was a transitional year. And now I'm planted in some different areas. And as our Sunday school in my lesson said today, bloom where you're planted. Bloom where you're planted. Be satisfied where you're planted. And bloom where you are planted. So I'm ready. We got to be ready. Pastor say, don't get ready. Be ready. So we ready. We willing. Willing. You got to be willing. And be obedient. And we shall have the good of the land on today. So I'm thankful today for what the Lord is doing, for he is doing great things, And I encourage you to expect great things in 2022. God is going to move mightily. We thought we did something last year. So get ready. We thought we did something last year. Oh, but we're going to do some things this year. Oh, we're going to do some greater things because greater things he has for us to do. So we're going to do some greater things this year. I don't know what it all looks like. I don't know. But I know we're doing greater because greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. So we don't have to falter. We don't have to fear. We don't have to worry about all that's going on in this world. And we know a lot of things are happening. We know a lot of things are happening. And we see in what we see. But we got to look past what we see and see God because he is the one. He's the one on today, saints. He is the one on today. So I'm encouraged. I hope you're encouraged. I hope your first week of the new year is going well. But I want you to know, saints, get ready. Get ready. Get ready. God is doing great things, and we are glad about it on today. We are here at First Church of God in Christ, where we believe in a lively worship of the Lord. God is doing amazing things, and we are glad about it on today. Saints, please pray for me as I continue to pray for you and do those things that God will have me to do. I thank God today for the victory in every area. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Come on, saints, put your hands together. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. That's right. Come on and put your hands together. Woo, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Just a little bit of this song. If I hold out just a little while longer. If I hold out just a little while longer. If I hold out just a little while longer. God's gonna give me the victory. If I hold out just a little while longer. If I hold out just a little while longer. If I hold out just a little while longer. God's gonna give me the victory. If I hold out just a little while longer. If I hold out just a little while longer. If I hold out just a little while longer. God's gonna give me the victory, the victory. The victory, 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 the victory. If I hold out just a little while longer, if I hold out just a little while longer, if I hold out just a little while longer, God's gonna give me the victory. Come on and put those hands together. Come on and bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. The battle, it don't belong to me. And it don't belong to you. But it belongs to the Lord. Will you give it to him? That's where you got to be. Will you give it to him? Hallelujah. Time out for trying to fight ourselves. We got to learn to turn it over to Jesus. And he'll make it all right. I said he'll make it all right. When you turn it over to the Lord, he'll make it all right. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, he will. Oh, yes, he will. I said God will. Yes, he will. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Woo! The battle don't belong to me, but it belongs to the Lord. hallelujah, that we get root and it root down deep in us. Hallelujah. So we thank God today for the wonderful and great word of God. The Lord is moving by his spirit. Amen. What a blessed word. What a blessed word of the Lord. Oh, saints of God and friends of mine, look, let me tell you a secret. When you get disciplined about something, or when you get reproved about something, don't say you're being beat down and all of this. Hey, the new word for now is, I learned a new way. I learned a better word, a better way. Amen? Because like our founder said, you ain't being beat down. You already down. I'm trying to bring you up. Hallelujah. So our new language for this year is, I've learned a better way. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That's the way you go with it and be strong in the Lord. And then the power of his might. Nobody's defeated but the devil. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We got to see ourselves more victorious. We got to see ourselves more as a conqueror. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because that's who we are as the saints of God. Amen. Glory to God. We're not sad. We're not down. We're not out. But we're happy. We're rejoicing in the great God of our salvation, because he has given us a better way. Hallelujah. And to know a better way. Woo! Glory to God. Add pages and 2 hour chapters. Did you hear what I say? It add pages unto our chapters. Because on this journey, you got a book to tell. Not a story. A story starts right here and it can end there. But when you got a book, glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. To write, it takes you on and on and on. It never ends. Hallelujah. But we give God praise today. We exalt the Most High God. We lift him up, for truly he is worthy to be praised. I love the Lord today. What about you? What about you? Do you love the Lord today? Amen. I was blessed by the word. I was strengthened by the word. I was encouraged by the word, because it was a word from the Lord. And I'm excited to see growth in these young ladies moving forward and growing in God and coming forth and bringing a word, an anointed word. Amen. Glory to God. So God is good. And I pray that you all that are on Facebook and YouTube and Zoom, that you have been blessed by the word of God. And we thank God for our speaker of the hour. Amen. So if you need prayer today, amen, we're going to bring our speaker up and let her pray for you. Amen. Right where you are, we want her to come and pray for you. And after that, we will turn it into the hands of those who are going to take the offering up. Amen. But right now, we want to pray. Let us pray. Amen.
Father, again, we just thank you and we praise you and we magnify your name. We thank you, oh God, for how you have moved. We thank you for the word, God, that the battles belong to you, oh God. Oh God, we ask that you would continue to touch and to move, God, upon every heart, breast to breast, God. Oh God, you see and you know what the needs are. You know what the struggles or the battles may be, oh God. Oh God, but you're the God of more than enough, God. You're able to do it, God. You're able to perform. You're able to bring it to pass, God. Lord, and we just thank you. We give your name praise, God. We thank you for what you're going to do. We thank you for how you're going to do it, God. Oh, God, we're forever to give you the glory, the honor, and the praise, God. Move by your spirit, God. Move by your power, God. Oh, God, and we just thank you, God, for all that you're going to do. There's none like you nowhere, God. You are the answer for today, God. You are the answer for today, oh, God. And, God, we just thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen.
And God bless you. At this time, we're going to turn it into the hands of our pastor, that he'll come forth at this time. Thank God. Thank God. After the offering, are we going to go forth with the offering now? Yes, we're going to make ready to receive our offering at this time, and we'll turn it into the hands of our pastor.